Hello, I'm Mr. Arnager, a retired lecturer in Matanagi, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. Nanak came in 1469 and preached gospel for 150 years through five more lives. Still the darkness could not be comprehended. Then our father himself came to sort out the stubborn sons of Satan with sole power and establish the last two communities of apostles and soldiers. Here I'm rendering exposition of John's gospel, which is a John 5 verse 17 to 30. Holy gospel of our supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., delivered by the first anointed Christ, which in Punjabi we call Satguru, Jesus, according to St. John 5, 17 to 30. Jesus answered the Jews, "My Father is at work until now, so I'm at work. Father is inside us." This is the temple of God. So God lives in his house as I'm living in my house, which this house belongs to Nijjar. So Father also lives in his house. If it's clean, if it's dirty, or you are a cheat, you are a hypocrite, then Satan is here, God is out. And that is why this temple of God is called Emmanuel. God is with us. So God is with us, and that is by his grace we get his word. And when you get his word, then you preach gospel, then it is not you who is speaking, but our Father is speaking through you. So our Father is supernatural, and this is natural, and our supernatural Father is of souls. And when he is inside you, then he gives all the power to his Son to take life or to give life. But Son is not allowed to take life. Son is to love everyone. That love is called divine love, agape, unconditional love. It is only Father who has the right to take this life of the person. Son gives. So my Father is at work until now, so I'm at work. For this reason the Jews tried all the more to kill him, because when he said his Father is inside, I'm his Son. Son represents Father. He is the seed of the Father. So they wanted to kill him because he proclaimed to be the God himself, which is Father, represented by his Son. Because he not only broke the Sabbath, but he also called God his own Father, making himself equal to God. That is right, you know, when in Jesus, you know, Jesus, remember the first, he told them, "We have one Father, we are brethren." And as they learned the subject of this, his word, and this, which is called philosophy or logical reasoning, then when they were sufficient, you know, efficient in his word, then Jesus called them friends. And the friend represents you. If you want to do something, you will send your friend, oh, go and tell him to give you £500, you know. And his friend will give you because you have sent him. It's the same thing as him coming there. So, in Jesus, when our Father is inside, then we are the representative of our Father. That's why Jesus came us to make the sons of the Most High, Elohim Allah Parbrahm. So, Jews were very angry, you know, because they didn't know the Father. Even so much so is that, you know, the Jewish rabbi, even today, a few weeks ago, I went to Oxford. Over there, somebody came to give a lecture from Jerusalem University. And I asked him, what is the difference between Yahweh and Elohim? He had no knowledge. He was looking at the rabbi. What shall he say? The rabbi told him, keep quiet. This is not for you. That means he was still keeping him mute. And the rabbi himself did not know either, because he had lost all the interest in it. Dead in letters. Broke the Sabbath, but he also called God his own Father, making himself equal to God. Jesus answered and said to them, Amen, Amen, I say to you, a son cannot do anything of his own, but only what he sees his Father doing. For what he does, his son will do also. Remember the trade, you know, if somebody is a carpenter, then the son will watch him, how he does the cut the wood, how he make it, plane it up and all that. And son is watching and he's learning the things from the father, you know. When the father dies, then the carpenter, the son will become the carpenter. He will do the same thing. So the secret of the trade is passed on to son. Same way, the secret of his word is passed on to son to represent him. In other words, son is the mark of father, is the seed of father, you know, for, and he being the salt of his father will do what his father wishes. Remember, Jacob had 12 sons. And out of those 12, only Joseph was doing what their forefather Abraham was doing. Truthful and righteous. The others were crook, you know. The 11 brethren of Joseph were not the salt of Abraham. And that is why Abraham kicked them out of the promised land. Abraham is only the father of the faithful, not of the unfaithful. When they became unfaithful to Abraham, by not representing his salt, not being righteous and generous, they wanted to kill Joseph. What for? Because he was righteous. And he will tell Jacob everything, you know, what is right. The others were twisting it. And so they said, we tell lies to our father, and this man tell the truth. Let us kill him, you know. So instead they sold him as a slave to the Egyptian. As soon as he left the promised land, there were none who was faithful to Abraham. And when there were none faithful to Abraham, then Abraham being the father of the faithful, he kicked them out with the help of Yahweh, who brought him planted him there. Yahweh is the one who feed you, give you rain and everything. So Yahweh stopped rain. He is jealous and revengeful. So if you have become unfaithful to Yahweh, unfaithful to Abraham, you have no right to live on this planet Earth. So they were kicked out of the promised land. They went to Egypt, where they suffered. And then Moses brought them back. Remember, two brethren in Egypt were fighting with each other. Moses said, hey, don't fight with your brethren. You have one father, Abraham. The aggressor said, who made you the judge? Get lost. So that was the rift between the two brethren, was the snake. While when Moses took them in the wilderness, made them to repent, not to be unfaithful to their father. When they became faithful to their father, then there was no rift between brethren. They were united. And when they were united, that is called the snake was lifted up. Moses lifted up the snake. And on the other hand, Jesus lifted up the cobras on international basis. I have put a video on this topic. You can watch it. So, the 11 brother of Joseph were not the salt of Abraham, and that is why Abraham kicked them out of the promised land. Yahweh would not give them rain to grow food. So the land became barren. This story was told by Jesus in the parable of the prodigal son. In this one, you know, the father is Abraham, the elder son is Ishmael, and the younger one is Isaac and his people. So that is what happened when the 11 were kicked out of the promised land. Moses made them faithful to Abraham, and the same land became lush green. For the father loves his son and shows him everything that he himself does. And he will show him greater works than these, so that you may be amazed. And that was the resurrection of Lazarus. He was dead for 4 days, and people will be thinking he would be rotten, you know, but he made him alive because he was son of the Most High. He was friend of Jesus. Friend means same qualities as Jesus. So in Lazarus, Jesus showed to the general public what his word can do to you. He can give you eternal life if you become the son of the Most High. Like father, like son. For just as the father raises the dead and gives life, so also does the Son give life to whomsoever he wishes. So remember, there was a widow whose only son died, and the whole village was very upset, you know, that there's nobody who will look after the widow. And Jesus went to that village, and they were carrying him away for burying. He stopped the funeral people and touched him, you know, to come and raise up. So life was given back to him. Widow was very happy. And that was making the dead boy of a widow alive. Nor does the father judge anyone, but he has given all judgment to his son, so that all may honor the son, just as they honor the father. So the sons are called saint, sons of the Most High. And here you are. This is the angels, the temple rabbis, priests and other things. Samaritans were ideal, you know. And these are the saints, the very sons of the Most High. Our Father is light, primary source of light. So these, all these saints, they have the primary source of light, which they get it through logical reasoning. Logical reasoning end product is logo, and logo is His word. And that will give you the picture of our Father. Whoever does not honor the Son does not honor the Father who sent Him. That means if He explains everything logically and you still don't believe Him, then you are not honoring Father who sent the person. For example, a Jew is one who is inwardly, spiritual self, a way of life, not outwardly. Outwardly they were tribal people, Judah tribe, Benjamin tribe, Levi tribe, and so. So tribal people are born, tribal people die. Not a Jew. Jew is inwardly, spiritual self. So during the Holocaust, not a single Jew died. But people of Judah tribe, Benjamin tribe, Levi tribe, they died, they were born. Not a Jew. So this fact, logo, if you tell to people, you can see how they will react. And this truth is known to very few people of discerning intellect who can think themselves. So, hello, Hanji, Hagi, Baldev. So, such things, you know, are known to those people who are the discerning intellect, who can think spiritually. I go to Germany, you know, Kirchentag. So many years I have been going, and 1 year I went to a Catholic Kirchentag. While at the bus stop I was standing there, I asked a local man, you know, and asked if he had also gone to Kirchentag. How many Jews died during the Holocaust? He said, zero. I said, how the hell you know this answer? He said, Jew is a spiritual self. As simple as that. And then I went with him. I kept his company so that we can promote gospel. But he was working as a porter in a hotel. And he told me, Mr. Niger, if I preach gospel, you know, my boss will sack me. So he gave up, you know. So, gospel is for those who are predestined. Whoever does not honor the Son does not honor the Father who sent Him. Amen. Amen. I say to you, whoever hears my word and believes in the one who sent me has eternal life and will not come to condemnation, but has passed from death in ego to life in Holy Spirit. That enables the person to know God in spirit. Now this is seem to be strange to you, but among the Sikhism, you know, We know that unless you kill ego, you cannot perceive God. Person of ego is once born. In order to be twice born, you should know that this is just a pot for identification. The soul in myself is the real self. If soul is gone, this body is just earth to earth, dead. So, Amen, Amen, I say to you, the hour is coming and is now here, when the dead in ego and living in Holy Spirit will hear the voice of the Son of God, Christ Jesus. And those who hear will live, because Jesus came to make us the sons of the Most High through His word, Oral Torah. For just as the Father has life in Himself or is eternal, so also He gave to His Son the possession of life in Himself. As Jesus presented Himself to the temple priest to sacrifice Him as the Lamb of God for the death of humanity. So, Lamb of God or death of humanity. That means people crook, you know, they always kill the poor people. They become rich at the expense of the poor. But the time is coming now, judgment time. Israel is 70 years old this year. In America, there are two things. God is on one side, Mammon is on the other side. Mammon and media. That is of Satan. They can twist the thing as they like it. But you can't twist God. So, Jews who went to America, they were not persecuted, because there was no majority of any tribe. When the English were English, they killed Jews. When the German became German under Hitler, they killed Jews. This is the common denominator. So in America, they flourished, and they control all the Mammon and media, as you can see in the world even. And the whole world is controlled by them. So they are Satan, and you will soon see their protection is going away this year. And how people will revolt against such hypocrites. There will be a lot of trouble coming. For 5 years there will be trouble. Five is concerned with the five temptation of the heart, which was the five husband of the Samaritan woman, which she had overpowered. Such language is not known to many. So if you watch my video, you might catch me. The temple priest killed him for no crime, as the sensible robber told the once-born robber, who said, you know, if you are the Christ, then save us. You have been making the dead people alive. Why can't you save me, you know? He told the Jesus. Then the other man, you know, who was a robber, who was sensible, he said, we are dying because we have committed crime. But this man has done nothing wrong. So you should be content, you know, that this man, if he's done nothing wrong, is being committed to death. How bad is the world today? Or how bad is the temple priest who condemned him, the ruler of the ruling party? So in this dark age, you know, you will see many injustices. So they are common. So, Robert, that we are punished for snatching riches from the rich to give it back to poor, like Robin Hood he was, you know, and he to the poor. But this man has given life to people, and he has not snatched any life under Bhakti Marg, under Bhakti Marg of the sons of God. Sons of God have no right to take the life, but to give. In churches, you know, people donate money to the church purse. As Judas Iscariot was holding the purse, people used to give money to the Jesus, and he put it in that purse. But he will steal money from the purse. Whenever he wanted something, he will dip his hand, steal money, and spend it. So he was a thief, which Jesus knew, and so were the apostles knew, rest of them, throughout their experience, how he was stealing money. So these dog on the priest in the churches, they are Judas Iscariot in sheep's clothing. They are stealing money from the church purse as their salary. They are not working for God, but working for mammon. And they, with the dog collar, they say they are men of God. This is called hypocrisy. In Jesus, we are royal priests. A royal priest have fellowship and not these ones. We are solitary. Each one give his own account to God. So this priest with the dog collar, can he give your account to God? No. The rabbi used to give the account of the people at Passover. And these can't give you. So they are antichrist. So if you have antichrist in the churches, you can't make progress. He's a blind, hypocrite person and making you blind too. If you want life, then be solitary, and wherever three or four together, sitting together, and Jesus is among you. But you must have temple clean of hypocrisy and greed. You must give to the church, not take money out of the church. That is Paul said, you know, I have given money to the church, I haven't taken money out of the church, which is right. Because in Moses, priests used to take tithe from the people, and that were the moral teachers. Spiritual preacher, they do opposite. What apply to flesh, the opposite apply to spirit. We give money to the church, we don't steal money out of the church. So, this is the Bhakti Marg. Under Bhakti Marg, our base is divine love called agape, unconditional love. So we cannot hate anyone, we cannot kill anyone, we cannot take life of anyone. So this is called Bhakti Marg in Punjabi. Marg means a way of life, Bhakti means worship of God. So Bhakti of God, who exercise agape love, divine, unconditional divine love. And he gave his power to exercise judgment because he is the son of man, the second noble Adam. Remember, Jesus' Hebrew name is Yeshua, made of two words, Yah from Yahweh, and Shoah means the primal Adam. So Jesus was the second Adam, first born of Yahweh, second Adam. And Mary was surrogate mother, Joseph was foster father. So that's why Jesus used to address Mary as woman and not as mother. these Jewish people, Messianic Jews, they have corrupted the New Testament as well. So they have introduced this word like disciple, Lord, etc. Jesus had no disciples. Rabbis have disciples. Disciples do what their teacher them tell them to do. The root of the word disciple is discipline. You discipline natural boys and not the supernatural or the twice born. Do not be amazed at this, because the hour is coming in which all who are in the tombs will hear his voice and will come out, those who have done good deeds to the resurrection of life, as Lazarus came out, but those who have done wicked deeds to the resurrection of condemnation, as the rich man had done, who ended up in hell. Remember, Lazarus was sitting in the lap of Abraham, and the rich man was getting roasted in hell. He asked Abraham, dip your finger in water and put it on my tongue. I'm so thirsty. Then Abraham told them that the separation between you and us is too great. We can't come to you. And then the rich man said, go and tell my brethren, five brethren or whatever it was, that not to cheat anyone. How they were being tormented. So you can see, you know, that in Lazarus, Jesus showed what his word can earn you, resurrection. You become the son of the Most High, like Father, like Son. I cannot do anything on my own. I judge as I hear people speaking logically his praises, and my judgment is just because I do not seek my own will, which is InshJesus. If we Insh mean willing, Jesus be willing. Not Jesus be willing, our Father be willing. This Islam is of Insh Mullah. Mullah be willing, not Allah. Inshallah, Islam is God be willing, not Mullah be willing. So these fatwas are Insh Mullahs. Seek my own will, Insh Jesus, but the will of the one who sent me, Inshallah. Allah, Elohim, and Parbrahm, they are the same thing. They are supernatural father. The word Allah is from Illah. Illah is our tribal father. Al-Illah, the father, spiritual father. This Islam of Mullahs, moon and star, is of Insh Mullah. So this Islam is a false Islam. And you can see in the Oxford University ago how they create debates on Islam and other thing. I tell them that this Islam is of Satan. They hate me. Never mind. So here you are. It's a lengthy one. And it's your, you know, gospel is by grace. Unless God gave you gospel, you can't have it. Peter was with Jesus all the time. He could not get gospel because he was once born. Only once Jesus gave him the taste of gospel, when he asked Peter, what do you think of me? He said, you are the living Christ of living God. Then Jesus told him, unless my Father gave you this knowledge, you can't have it. And then he became arrogant, you know, start rebuking Jesus. Ah, You are not going to die. You make the dead people alive. How can you die? Stupid man. And then Jesus rebuked him, you know, that you do not know the things of God. You only know the things of men, which the once-born people know. Twice-born people only know the things of God. Whoever is born, he will die. A Niger is born, Niger will die. Not a Christian or a Sikh or a Muslim or Hindu. Our Father God, bless you.